been a couple hours, so are you awake? Are you ready for this week of college basketball? Now, again, it is the week of Christmas, and the NBA is going to overshadow this week especially. But I don't think that we should completely forget about college basketball. I don't think we should completely forget about this fact and how things are going to go this week. You know, we have an interesting game on NBA's opening night, which is another conference game for Kansas, this time taking on Bob Huggins and his stout West Virginia Mountaineers crew. And again, you know, it could be another low-scoring game, just like the game last week with Texas Tech for Kansas. Now, they gotta really get it all together. You got lucky last time. But Big 12 conference play is no slouch. No slouch at all. So, we get to Wednesday. There are a couple of games on Wednesday. First, it is Xavier taking on Creighton. Paul Scruggs and Zach Fremantle and the undefeated Xavier team has been doing all sorts of things on offense. They can score at will. They can shoot the three ball. But Creighton, they still got Marcus Zagrowski and everything like that. And all those guys, those are shooters out there, I'm telling you. Creighton is shooting 50% from the field. That is how good this team is. That is how good these two teams are. And the fact that it took so long for Xavier to get ranked, I don't know what in the world is going on. Anyway, what about the other game Wednesday? Other big top 25 matchup on Wednesday, that would be Rutgers taking on Ohio State. Now, I've seen Ohio State, you know, at least once already. That was, you know, about a couple days ago on Saturday. But this will be my first time seeing Ron Harper Jr. and the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, which boast a legitimate claim to say, hey, we want that title too. We don't just want the Big Ten title. We want that national title. And I mean, Rutgers can score. They can do all sorts of things on offense and defense. And you know, the fact that they've proven themselves already with a big win against Illinois is going to be something. There's also Ohio State Northwestern on Saturday. So Northwestern has a lot of guards. Pete Nance, Ryan Lear, and Roy Dixon III. A lot of guards from Northwestern. I'll see how they match up with Ohio State. So I'll see the Buckeyes twice this week. So I wonder how that's going to go. On Christmas, there is Wisconsin, Michigan State. Both of these teams have a loss somewhere. You know, Wisconsin more recently than Michigan State. But, you know, both these teams are going to be looking to prove something while the NBA is going on. I don't know if I'll be able to watch this game. I might not. But, you know, it's going to be interesting to see how this plays out on Christmas. Of course, there's going to be COVID cancellations and everything like that. And, again, this week is really highlighted by the Big Ten. There's also Indiana, Illinois on Saturday as well. Trace Jackson Davis, you know, how he's going to go up against Kofi Coburn and Ayo Dosunmu, you know, for Illinois. Illinois is looking to bounce back. I think they got another game this week. I'm not sure which game it is. I did not pay attention to that fact. But, you know, these are big-time matchups for the Big Ten. This is really the highlight of the Big Ten. The Big Ten has been highlighted all week. There's even, you know, other games on Christmas as well. I know Iowa is taking on Minnesota on Christmas, and Michigan is taking on somebody, I forgot who they're taking on Christmas. I want to say, I don't know who it is, but it doesn't really matter. They're taking on somebody on Christmas. Michigan is, they're ranked still. And then, you know, we got the UCF Knights, Brandon Mahan, who's been playing great this past couple weeks, especially that game against Florida State earlier. And how are they going to go up against Houston? Well, the last time I saw the Houston Cougars, they were putting a beating on Texas Tech. They were putting a beating on them. And the defense was just damn good in that game. And even when, you know, the offense couldn't score for the Cougs, defense was lights out, shut down, to the point where Texas Tech could not come back and win that game. But, alas, 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 we have probably another big matchup that could potentially, you know, just say, hey, this could be ours. This could be our year. And I'm talking about those Gonzaga Bulldogs taking on the Virginia Cavaliers on Saturday. It'll be at 3, so it'll be in between all the nonsense that's going on with bowl season, the NFL games that are also on that Saturday, and the NBA coming back. So what Gonzaga could do is just light up this Virginia defense like it's nobody's business, or Virginia could put the brakes on it, you know, play a good defensive game. I mean, Gonzaga's going to score. They're going to score regardless, unless, you know, Virginia can shut it down. And there's just way too many talented players on Gonzaga. I mean, this is just talented. This is a talented group. And I know, it sounds like I've been sucking off Gonzaga for the past few weeks, but I mean, hey, we can all say it, that they're the number one team in the country. They've proven themselves as the number one team in the country before they get into West Coast Conference play. And I know the West Coast Conference, you know, people always like to whine and moan about the West Coast Conference and stuff like that. But hey, that conference is no slouch. You see the BYU already got a big victory against a ranked team on San Diego State, or formerly ranked, I think, in San Diego State already. Do not write that conference out. Do not write that conference out. Remember, Virginia got upset early in the season by San Francisco. Do not write that conference out. It could be a tough time for the Zags in conference play. Do not write that out. But the Big Ten, it is looking like it is going to be a dogfight with how many games I think I'm going to watch this week. And not much for the Big East here, not much for the Big 12. There's some big matchups. I think most programs are probably taking Christmas off. I don't blame them. You know, COVID has been rampaging college basketball, and it's hard to keep track of what games are getting canceled, what games are not getting canceled, and it's just like, whatever at this point. So, what I see on, you know, when I check Google and stuff like that, when I check what the games are going to be on the Monday when the AP rankings are released and stuff like that, I just go ahead and go. So, you know, so Tuesday, Wednesday, and especially, you know, Saturday, gonna be good. Gonna be good stuff. Keep an eye on the Big Ten on Christmas as well. There are some Big Ten games on Christmas, but honestly, the priority might be NBA. So I'll see you guys later on for, you know, talking about, you know, the NBA and the NFL. And maybe some bowl games as well. I don't know which ones I'm going to do this year. Because I know the New Year's Day bowls, those are obviously going to be watched by me. And the Texas Longhorns bowl game, which was the Alamo Bowl. I know that's going to be watched by me. So that's at least 10 games, maybe more. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. But until tomorrow to talk about the NFL and what Week 15 brought us in the National Football League. I'll see y'all later.